What's going on, my friends? Dustin with Electrician U. A little out of breath. As you guys can see, I'm in beautiful Breckenridge, Colorado right now. So I noticed something here when we got here. Electrician, right? Always looking for problems. I went to get in the hot tub. It was like 10 degrees outside. And I'm like, yo, I want to get in this hot tub for sure. And we turned it on and we had one of the jets going. Everything was fine. Went to turn the other jet on and everything shut off. The LED display, everything just boom, just dead. So I was like, we tripped a breaker for sure. So went over, there's GFCI breakers like there should be. There's two of them though, there's a 20 and a 30. Now, these don't actually look like they're tripped, but we just lost everything on our display over there. But Square D, notorious for this, the handle's actually tripped. So you gotta turn it all the way off, flip it all the way back on. This one's fine, but I'm gonna trip anyways. Still got our GFCI protection, so we're good. They said that they just got a brand new hot tub. So what I'm thinking is they probably have a hot tub that's sized larger than the conductors and the overcurrent devices, the breakers. So sure enough, I went and reset the breakers. Everything was fine. As long as we just kept it on low, we had no issues. But it was any time that you got both of them on together, both of those pump motors, it would trip the breaker. So I figured I would just open that and show it to you, talk a little bit about the code and sizing breakers and everything for these motors. Now, before we get started, make sure you get your U-Crew merch. So we've got Electrician U shirts right now. We've got a whole bunch of variations of hats. So if you want just the Electrician U EU logo, or you can get the U-Crew. If you want to be part of the U-Crew, come on, come join us, U-Crew. But go get your merch right now. We sell out very, very quickly, so they're for a limited time only, but we're constantly adding new stuff. There's all kinds of people that have been throwing tons of suggestions at us. But if you want any EU merch, check out the link below, electricianu.com. All right, so as far as what code has to say about any of this hot tub stuff, I thought there was a few relevant codes to bring up just to talk about the various codes that there are. So to start out, we've got 430.6, which talks about ampacity and motor determination, and 430.6 is really what we figure out our conductors and our breakers. So with motors, one thing that we've talked about in the past is that motors, they don't just call them overcurrent protection. There's two different kinds of protection that we have to do with motors. One of them is the short circuit and ground fault protection. So if there is a short circuit or a ground fault, we have one thing that we deal with. The other one is the overload protection. So 430.6A1 talks about conductor ampacity and branch circuit ground fault protection. Instead of using the current rating on the motor nameplate, we actually have to use these tables, 430.247 through 430.250. So specifically for us, we have a single phase motor. It's 230 volt motor. There's two of them and they're 2.5 horsepower. So you actually have to go to table 430.248 and look at the FLC numbers. So you go under the column for 230 volts, you look at what the horsepower of the motor is rated, and then you figure out what the current rating of the motor is rather than relying on what the nameplate actually says for the amperage. This is just for the short circuit and the ground fault protection. So we have two 2.5 horsepower motors, they're 230 volts. So on the table, you notice there's only a 2 horsepower and a 3 horsepower motor. There is no 2.5 horsepower. So you can kind of guesstimate the in-between values. So I'm going with 14.5 amps. A 2 horsepower motor would be 12 amps. A 3 horsepower would be 17. So I just kind of went in the middle and I'm guessing about 14.5 amps. So a 20 amp breaker on each one of them should be fine, but you also have to account for the heating. And I think that the reason that this is tripping, unfortunately, I don't have a multimeter. I can't check any values. I don't have any tools up here with me. So I'm just guesstimating that with both of the motors running and the heat that this 30 amp breaker is actually tripping. And that's probably what's going on. There isn't a ground fault. There's no short circuit happening. It's just an overload that's happening. So it's too much current that's running on the circuit at one time. But I really can't investigate too much more because I don't have the tools available. So some other things to note if you're looking up disconnecting means or ground fault protection or anything like that, we have to go to 680. So 680 is for pools, fountains, and similar, specifically 680.13, which I think is a violation in this situation. It's for maintenance disconnecting means. And it says that the disconnecting means should at least be 5 feet from the edge of the water away. This is probably about 4 feet. It's pretty close, but I'm gonna call that a code violation. And the idea there is, like, if somebody is sitting in water and they can in any way reach anything electrical, they could get shocked. So they do say that if there's at least a barrier within that 5 foot space, then that's one of the exceptions to that rule. The other thing is 680.32 talks about ground fault circuit interrupter protection. So anything, receptacles, plugs, lights, anything around this pool equipment all has to be GFCI protected, which this is. So all in all, I really don't know why it's tripping. There's a number of things it could be. It could be that the GFCI breaker is bad. It could be that there's something going on that's causing that GFCI breaker to trip and it's not bad, but there's still something there. It could be a combination of the pumps on together. It could be the heat introduced to everything. Without a multimeter, I can't really do much, but my worry was, we're staying in a house out here. They just got this new hot tub and I was like, man, what if it's, what if the breaker and the conductors are undersized for what's available? But the cool thing is, even if that were the case, they've got a sub panel out here that's good for 60 amps. So they should be able to run new conductors if that were the case. But going off of these nameplate values, I don't really know. But again, without checking with the heat on and having my multimeter on using my ammeter and then trying to clamp onto those conductors and actually see what's happening when the motors turn on, there's not really much that I can do. So that's all I've got for you, my folks. I'm going back snowboarding. I'll see you later. Oh yeah, here's a picture of me on the lift. When you don't bring face protection out with you when you're snowboarding, this is what you look like. All right, crazy people, I love you, and I'll see you guys on the next one.
Discount music and video.